Hello, my friend, and welcome back to your daily dose of Broodwar. We've got a bit of a long one here today. SSAK down in the bottom right hand corner. We're going to be taking a long look at some of his games in January of 2024. I had some comments asking me to do a deep dive on this man before we get into ASL, so that's what we're going to be doing. But we're just going to be taking a look at some of his Terran versus Zergs, all the Zerg players he played against. There's a lot of big names in there. We've got Queen. Also, we got JAEDONG. We got Action. We got Calm. It's going to be a lot of fun, guys. I'm going to be taking a especially close look at each of the Zerg players here. Been struggling a little bit with Zerg versus Terran on the ladder. And guys, I just finished my first ever live stream in my new apartment. So we're going to be doing a whole bunch of live streaming here coming up. And yeah, it was really nice to see a bunch of you guys coming out to support and to watch me epically fail on the ladder. But we had a good time. We had a good time, and I'm going to be doing live streaming about 4 or 5 days per week is my goal. My New Year's resolution, if you will. And I'm aiming for A rank, because I've been high B rank for quite some time. I've been topping out around 2,000 MMR. I'm like 1,900 Zerg right now. The ladder just reset, so it's a good time to really dig deep, practice hard, keep learning, and eventually get up there into A rank. I'd love to at some point get into S rank, but still a long way to go for that. So come join me on my stream here. That's going to be every day around 9 a.m. Japanese Standard Time, which is around dinner time in North America. And SSAK, we've got starting off with a wall in here, and that has been spotted by the Overlord. And Queen didn't send out an early drone, which I've found that a lot of Zerg players in their most recent meta have been sending out a very early drone just to check and see if there is an 8 Rex coming. Because instead of placing the Rex here, you could place the Rex out in the front here. Build your supply depot bank here, 8 racks, put on a lot of pressure, and then just float your racks back into this wall, and you can be very, very safe after putting on a lot of pressure in the early game. And the one way that you can really see Zerg players deal with that efficiently is by sending out an early, early drone. Like, let's say you extract your trick on 9, get the 10th drone and send that across the map. You could end up, you know, catching the SCV making the barracks, kind of slow that down. And actually, we are going to see a bunker rush here. Bunker rush is coming, and the drones are just going to be pulled off now, but it's a little bit late. We've got 3 sets of links coming. Oh, don't lose the drone. Okay, he keeps the drone alive. The bunker is not nearly close to completion, and the SCV is way too low for these Marines to stick around, for this SCV to try and finish the bunker. So it looks to me like this is over already. SSAK is going to be shoved back. This bunker rush is done. All the Marines are going to end up going down. And I mean, target that SCV for the love of God. There we go. He does get it. And can now just return to full on drone production. Queen has the money to throw down another hatchery. Looks like he will do over here on the center left. Has himself quite a large advantage at this point. We'll be feeling pretty darn good about his position. 2 Marines here behind the wall. What do we have back at home? 2 more barracks coming forward here. And Queen not getting too greedy. Produced the right number of links and held that bunker push, or that bunker push pretty darn well. 4 racks follow up with that +1, nearing about that halfway mark. We're gonna have to wait a little bit. Oh, this Marine here needs to pull back. There we go. He does pull back that little tiny bit. Kind of funny to see, you know, you can't actually get through here with a Ling, but I guess you can hit the Marine if it's right on the diagonal. 5 mutas on the way. I'm gonna start those turrets up just now. This is the weak spot of this build, is right here. Of course, you can always come in from another angle and try to hit this supply depot as well, but it's going to be hard to defend this area. Just in general, when you're going for a build like this. 5 racks. Ah, we haven't seen a 5 racks for a while. It's been mostly 4 racks, I feel, for a really long time. And now that quicker factory seems to be much more meta, but 5 racks in this game. Let's see how it goes. Mutas are flying into the main now. 5 mutas can take on a turret. It's not that easy. Marines are going to start to move out a little bit. He sees the 5 racks. And the mutas do have to respect the move out here. We're just about at +1 and range. We do not want to fight just yet as SSAK. We're waiting for those 2 upgrades. And the moment that those are done is when our power spike begins. 8 mutas flying in here. Gonna start to get some good SCV kills, but he does have to respect the Marine move out. So far, not really giving the respect it deserves, but now he will start to fly back. Try to catch up with this Marine medic group. +1 just about to finish. So now SSAK is ready to fight. There's no +1 done on these mutalists, so he can take some good trades here. Good first volleys from Queen, though. Dealing some good damage there. Really, a lot of Marines are going to be popping out here with that 5 Rex play. Very hard to keep up with that. Nice medic snipes, though. Very hard to keep up with that with just producing, you know, Mutalis here on 2 base. And now he's got the 3rd gas sort of operational. He's going to be able to produce a lot more Mutas, but look at this. He's not transitioning at all. Just pure Mutalist production on 3 gas. And he is just going to keep on pumping these out, adding on a bunch of sunken colonies. He's going to trade in here. I think he's going to go all in, dive over these turrets, maybe go for the main base while defending at home with sunken colonies. This is a risky maneuver, but it could pay off really, really well here for Queen if done properly. He will sacrifice the 3rd. He's even going to pull the drones out of here preemptively, realizing that that base is a sacrificial lamb here. Diving in, going to start to kill the turrets. Killing off turrets in the main here. Going to go after the Marines now. Does force the liftoff. Liftoff so that the Marines can get closer to these mutas, can track them down without being kind of pushed away by that command center. That's a very good move by SSAK, and it will drive the mutalists back. And while the mutalists are pushed out, oh, he dives right on top of these Marines. Yikes. Just a full-on attack here with these mutas. Has 12. Too many for one full control group, but good God, a lot of SCVs are going down now. A lot of SCV damage here. And we are so low on the Marine count right now. He picks off that one extra muta, which is very nice. But he's losing way too many SCVs here. He's got 21 SCVs in that tiny little stack right there. A little bit less than that, I guess. Maybe 18 SCVs there. As there are 3, 4 now in the main base. Fighting these Marines at the bottom of the ramp is very good. And I think that SSAK will have to retreat all the way home with his forces out here on the map. Still eight mutalists in the main. Gonna get a few more kills. Beautiful micro here from Queen. Getting as much damage as is entirely possible here. And still has a full 2 base mining, whereas SSAK is really struggling right now to get any mining going at all. He is mining here in the natural, but his main base has been completely ravaged. Queen looking unstoppable here. He's got that full group. He's probably going to split them into 2 groups of mutas, but I think he walks over this, no problem. Here we go, just going to walk over these Marines. He will trade out quite a few mutas, but killing every single Marine here is going to be absolutely worth it. All the medics go down as well. That is totally worth right now for Queen. He's going to take his third base once again. Can continue this pressure here and maybe dive back on top of this mineral line once again. The main has not been reestablished with turrets. We're just holding everything off with this group of Medic Marine. Man, it is impressive to see Queen overwhelm a 5-Rax player. 5-Rax plus 1 Marine Medic player being overwhelmed here just by pure Mutalisk spam. And he's getting into an armor upgrade as well, which is crazy. We do have armor and attack upgrades now for these Marines. They are very strong. But that one armor is actually going to make a big difference here, I think. Marine damage is so high. It's so affected by something like a plus one. So an armor upgrade is really going to make a huge splash for these Mutalisks that are flying in now. Going to go into the main base. Start to pick off some turrets. Wow, look at how quickly these turrets are getting picked off. I think that's two groups of Mutas here. Diving back in on top of the Marines is going to pick them off super quick. And GG is called. Sock taps out. There's no way to transition into something like a science vessel from there. He dealt way too much damage to Sock's economy. Queen going to stay here and just finish off all of those Marines. Kind of basking in the glory of this victory. Pure Mutaman. Overwhelming Sock here in game number one. All right, next up we've got HYUK versus SSAK. HYUK, a little bit weaker of an opponent than someone like Queen. Queen just absolutely crazy with the Mutalisk micro and just overall decision making with those Mutas. How he gets that damage, so impressive to watch. And just unbelievable that he's able to overwhelm the 5-Rax with pure Muta. Generally, when you see that 5-Rax, it's really accepted and understood for the Zerg player to, like, as soon as you see that, you fly in there with the first few Mutas, you see, oh, you're going for 5-Rax? Hydroden. Instant Hydroden, because you know that the science vessels are going to be very late. And your opponent is going to have a ridiculous amount of Marines to fight with the just pure Muta. It's going to be insane. The number of Marine that the Terran player can field. So, bucking the trend, Queen, not interested in making any sort of tech transition, just bulldozing over SSAK in that game. I believe that was on January 1st. This is another game from early January here in 2024. HYUK, gonna start off with a 12 hatch. And all is well in the world of the Zerg. We're gonna throw down another wall here for SSAK. And what is he going to pull here this game? Is he gonna go for another bunker rush on this natural? Well, HYUK, he's got something to say about that. He is the type of guy to pull an early drone. And this is what I was saying. It's very much meta these days. Oh, what is this drone doing? He's like floating. That's funny. He doesn't look like he's walking at all. Or floating. I guess they float anyway, don't they? All workers float, don't they? But really, he looks like the animation is just completely stuck here. Maybe it'll reset now. There we go. Animation restored. All Zerg players these days do pull those early drones, just to make sure that there's nothing cheeky coming. You also really want to know if there's some sort of gas build, and checking the barracks is the best way to find out if that is coming or not. If you see Marines continuously pumping out, you're pretty certain that there's not going to be a gas build. Like some sort of factory timing with a vulture coming out very early. In this case, there is going to be that gas, but I think it's going to be eBay. There it is. eBay on the way. We'll be going for another early upgrade build here. Pushing out on the map again with three Marines. Let me just go ahead and change the colors here. That's a little bit better. Brown is always a little tough to see on the minimap and on the screen as well. Go ahead and change that to blue. And he's going to be going for that plus one build. I believe it should be a two racks plus one, but we still do need to have that academy. And we'll see if he throws down another racks in a moment here. Try to get that marine number up in preparation for that plus one. Or will he go five racks again? Five racks again would be a little bit funny. It certainly didn't work well against Queen, but there's a reason why it was super popular back in the day. Like, pre-remastered, five racks into SK Terran was the build. That was like, that was the one that Flash was just so good at that you could never really overwhelm him in the mid game when he had that many Marines and Medics out on the map. The five racks really gives you the mid game power of the Marine Medic. And here we go. More racks being thrown down in the main base. We're going up to three. We'll see how many he decides to throw down. But a third base is on the way here for HYUK. Dropping a Spire as well. The timing is looking pretty much a two hatchery timing. With just 3 meters on the way. Not able to make the full six at the beginning when this hatchery or when this Aspire finishes, but that's okay. He has the third base on the way here. He's prioritizing his mid-game economy over getting out that initial six mutas immediately. And look at this, we're going up to four racks. Now, this is still standard play in today's meta. The four racks plus one is a very strong build. And it'll give you a much faster factory than something like a five racks play, because you're not pumping out as many Marines, right? It's not only the minus 150 for that extra barracks, but it's also the production, you know, coming here. You have to build more supply depots. You have to build all those Marines. There's no point in getting extra racks if you're not going to use it. So you're keeping pumping, and that's going to slow down your factory just a little bit. Now, coming in with this first group of Muta, it is taking a bit of damage. We haven't seen any kills here for Hyuk's Muta so far. And the timing for them to be strong has just about run out, because the Marines are about to get their plus one and they've already finished range. So this is going to become, you know, the game is going to be in Sock's hands here. From this point on, can he get a kill? Oh, a missed opportunity there to snipe a medic. Yuck. Not looking too good with this initial Mutalisk harassment. Has plus one on the way. Plus one armor is coming forward here. Sock is going to start to move out. A lot of links have been made. And it appears like Yuck wants to gamble on being able to pick off a big group of Marine Medic. Here shortly, diving on top of these turrets, is going to pick off two, and a third will go down. He lost one Muta. He's done a good job so far. Oh, the Marines are actually going to, or the Lynx are going to counterattack in while the Mutas are dealing their damage, but he didn't combine very well the Mutas and the Lynx, and looks like all the Marines have been pulled back at least. I thought that Sock was just going to counterattack across the map, and I think if he had done so, he probably would have just won this game. Yuck is diving so deep, and there are no sunkens over here, so maybe a bit of a mistake by Sock. He saw that the turrets were getting picked off here, and his army was out in the front. If he had pulled the trigger and just gone straight across the map, I don't think that Yuck could have held it, but now he's back here. He's regained control over his main base, and he hasn't really lost any SCVs, so I think he's still in a decent spot here. You can see the factory is done. We have some starports coming up now. He's still taking some damage, but I think he's feeling pretty okay at this point. Hydralis Den and Queen's Nest on the way for Hyuk. Making that transition into Hive now. What did he scan? I don't see where that scan was. Maybe trying to find the Mutas out in front of the base. I'm not sure. Diving in here, this is a very hard place to fight for the Terran. Killing off quite a few of those SCVs, losing just one Muta so far. Getting a few more kills here, picking off a medic or two. Getting some Marines as well. Not bad at all. Here comes a small contingent of Marines across the map. Those are just donations, it looks like, to the Zerg Swarm. We've got a sunken colony here. Oh, maybe you could get some drone damage here, actually. This could be big. Drone damage right now is huge. Killing off a ton of drones. What's that? 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 drones. 10, 11 drones have gone down. 12 drones have fallen. And one sunken colony could have prevented all of that pain. Such an unfortunate turn of events here for HYUK, who just wasn't paying attention to the move out of SSAK. Did not have any links, anything in position to spot that coming his way. And now he's dropped down to 26 drones. Oh man, this is painful here. Can you imagine losing the game to just 5 Marines with no medic support walking across the map? I can imagine it because it's happened to me before. That shit is painful. Here we go. Getting in on this base once again. Picking off that turret, but that's fine. SSAK is 100% happy with his position now. He's got double science vessel production. He knows exactly where his opponent is at and that his opponent needs to build more drones, but he really can't afford to. Look at this. No drones being built to replenish the forces here. He is just going to try and all in him from this point. He's going to get his defiler mound. He's going to build some defilers. He's got some lurkers here. He's going to try and ram them down the throat of SSAK and see if he can see if he chokes. But I don't think he will. SSAK here in a good position to fight these mutas. He's going to go after the science vessel. Can he get it? First kill on the science vessel is huge. Picking that science vessel off before it could get even one irradiate down. Muta's here dancing in and out, trying to get a little more damage. He should move the lurkers a bit further forward, and he will now. But SSAK is ready for this. He's going to pull that trigger with these. Oh my god, the spine's actually killing so much. He hits the stim button, but it's not good enough. Running right down the throat here. Straight on top of these science vessels and Marines. He gets a lurker right in the front. The bunker is empty, guys. He's running up into the main base. This is craziness. The lurker's getting killed actually by SCVs right now, but it looks like HYUK may just be able to pull this one off. He's managed to kill a lot of these SCVs, and he's forced SSAK back into a very uncomfortable position. It's so tempting to stay here on top of these barracks, but I'm not sure this is a good idea. Staying right here could lead to him getting locked in this base and not being able to utilize those first few defilers. He gets completely surrounded. Yeah, getting down to the bottom of the ramp here might have been a better decision. Staying on top of that was so juicy, though. Staying on top of the racks means that you can continuously throw down kills on those Marines as they're popping out. But here we go. SSAK has not been moving with his vessels. He has not prepared for this eventual defiler play that was going to come in here. And now the defiler is right in his natural. Another Dark Swarm should be thrown down here. He will throw that down. More defilers making their way forward, and there's nothing that SSAK can do about it right now. He's going to throw down another Dark Swarm here and continue this push. SSAK backing up to high ground. He knows he just really needs to survive right now, pumping out fire bats to try and keep himself alive. Will he go for D-Matrix? No, more irradiates going down. I like the decision. D-Matrix here is strong, but there's just so few lurkers, and he spreads, and he does get the surround here. He will finish off the last of the lurker and pushes back. HYUK, has he done it? Can he stabilize from here? He does need to get this CC down in order to keep himself alive. I'm so shocked that HYUK has managed to do as well as he has, though, with so few units left over. He's going to try and dive in here, get a kill on one of these science vessels, but he hasn't been able to get any kills on them. And things are slowly getting pushed further and further back now. Plague is about to finish with one consume. Does he have the plague ready? Oh, it's so close. There it is. Plague is done, but he does not have the plague energy here. And the lurkers are going to fall. That's it. GG. Sock pushes through the rally here and manages to take this game. What an intense back and forth here between SSAK and HYUK, but that's just game number two, guys. We've got plenty more to come. Next on our list, as we dive deeper into SSAK's backstory leading up to this ASL qualifying round, Calm here in the top right-hand corner, SSAK down in the bottom left. We're here on Polypoid and Calm. He did very well last ASL, by the way, guys. Very, very well. I think that SSAK didn't even make it in to the group stages last season, although we were really expecting him to go deep based on his performances in the KCM. It was looking like he was going to have an amazing run, but ended up getting knocked out by an unfortunate series of events. I remember he got knocked out by that player that no one expected to see. I can't remember his name now, but there was one like nameless player that nobody knew who he was. He managed to get into the group stages last year, and he managed to do it through SSAK. He managed to knock out SSAK. So that was a surprise, a huge surprise, and I'm looking forward to seeing SSAK again this ASL, or I guess I say again, but he has been in ASLs before, right? So hopefully we'll see him again this ASL, and he can give us a really good performance, but regardless, we'll be watching him and keeping a close eye his performance in KCM as well as in these ladder battle series. I had some comments on one of my last videos to show more Overlord butt. There it is. If you missed that last cast, I was saying that the Overlord butt kind of reminds me of a bonobo. You know, when their butts get all red and what is it? Inflamed or something? No, they're like in heat, right? Kind of looks like that to me. A little weird scrunchy butt. I don't know what else that reminds me of. Maybe like a moth or something like that. They have like a weird back end at some point in their metamorphosis. Now, Calm here, he's got that drone out in the front. At least keeping a drone out in the front early is really, really good these days. Making sure that the SCV isn't starting a barracks. At least if it does, you can start to put some damage on that and get prepared to pull the rest of your drones. If the bunker starts and you just start to pull drones at that moment, the bunker is almost halfway done before your drones even make it out here to start that harassment. So that can lead you to a very bad situation where the SCV can just pull off, the Marines pull up, and then the SCV can start again, finish off that bunker very quickly, and then you end up in a very bad position. So I like to see Calm here bringing out the early drone there, and he might be able to get this. There it is. He does get the SCV. A great pick off here for Calm, and he will send his remaining two Lings across the map. Now, it's a little scary. SSAK is moving out with a couple of Marines, and look at this. He's going for Engineering Bay first again. A really loving the early upgrade play is SSAK. Good awareness here from Calm. Calm, one of the most popular Brood War streamers in Korea right now, has been incredibly popular. Him along with Brittany, and who else is really popular? I believe Shuttle, super, super popular. There's one more guy, but I just can't remember who he is right now. C, that's him. C has not been performing well in ASL or anything like that for a long time, but his streaming career absolutely popped off. So there's no need to really get competitive in Broodwar anymore when you can make money by just live streaming. Spire here on the way. It is a 2.5 hatch for Calm. Calm, even though he is a very popular live streamer, still looking for that dream. The dream of getting the ASL. The ASL title. And it looked like he had was going to have a very good run last season. Didn't get as far as I think he was hoping. I think he was hoping for like a top 4 or something like that. But I believe he got knocked out in the early group stages. To the chagrin of all the people who were supporting him in his live stream. I know that the days that he was playing were some of the most hype days in the studio audience. So many people cheering for that guy. This guy right here. With those little webbed feet. Those are the cuties. Look at the human hands on these bad boys. You ever notice that they've got little claws like that? Poking out of the top of their head? I don't think I've ever seen... I remember I watched the Starcraft FPS. I believe I watched Tasteless Blade or something like that. I don't think they really did the Lynx justice. They look more like Starcraft 2 Lynx, which do look a lot different than Starcraft 1. Starcraft 1 Lynx look very freaky. The way that their bodies are modeled. And they really did not look the same in before remastered. They look totally different now. I'm going to go ahead and pick off the first turret. Opening up this area. And we always talk about this. This area is super vulnerable to the Mutalisk harassment. And it's really important to get that turret there and to keep it alive. Because otherwise the Mutalisk will just abuse the heck out of you. Calm being a little bit passive with his Mutalisk, not diving in as hard as we saw from Queen in that game number one, but he has a good reason not to be doing that. He's adding on a third base right now, and he's gone for 2.5 hatch, which means he has a stronger mid game. This early attack with the Mutalisk, though, is a little bit weak. He's forcing out some stims here. The medic energy is getting still pretty high here, not too bad. Coming in, gonna pick off a couple of turrets now. He actually didn't need to go for that last swipe because the turret was going to burn down on its own. Marine Medic just sitting out here at the front. I'd love to see this Marine Medic start to move maybe across the map to actually threaten the counterattack here, but SSAK is actually gonna catch the Mutas that are leaving the main base. That was a great catch, actually. Two Lynx gonna come in here and get some damage on the turret, but the repair is strong. What am I looking at here? Oh my god. Calm. Holy crap, dude. That is a big mistake here. That is a tenth of the economy. Sitting down at the bottom center, just doing absolutely nothing. Calm gonna be kicking himself for this one later. If he watches this replay, which he might not even watch the replay and just wonder why he lost, but missing three drones is pretty brutal. More and more Mutas being made here. It feels like Calm wants to play this similar to the way that Queen did, with just a ton of Mutalisk production coming out, an absolutely huge amount. He is going to transition eventually into this Hydralis den, but he is pumping out Mutas like mad here and going to try and fight the Marine Medic Ball in the middle of the map. But SSAK has pulled everything together. He's got a big group here and is going to be reinforcing that as well. He's got the science facility down. He has one starport. So he is ready to transition and calm this... You know, continuous Mutalisk spam is not going to do you too well once those science vessels are out. So He does need to make something happen here pretty soon, and that's why he's getting a little desperate. Flying in and taking trades with the Marines that aren't even moving right now. If they're just standing in a box formation like that, it is nearly impossible to take a good trade. Like, you try to take a good trade with a box of Marines like that. It's very, very hard. Gonna come in and take one swipe, but not getting any kills, and SSAK is doing the right thing, just sitting and waiting for his science vessel. Lot of Lings coming up. Look at all the Mutas and Lings here, and he's about ready to take a fight, but SSAK is sitting completely stationary, exactly where he wants to be, in a big ball here, ready to take this fight. Here comes all the Lings. Oh my god, they're not coming in from a very good angle here. He's gonna dive on top of all of this. Huge force of Lings just getting mopped up by these Marines. Beautifully held here. Beautifully held. Not a very good engagement by Calm. You really want to have like two angles of Lings so they come in from, you know, multiple sides and get a good surround, but he really did not have that. All of them kind of grouped up on top of that. Was brutal. Just so bad for the Zerg player who's been kind of gathering up that massive force for a very long time, hoping to shut down SSAK completely on this map, just take away that map control. Failed to do so, and now he's just sitting here with five Muta, trying to slow down the third base while transitioning into some Lurker, and I think that's going to fail as well. He will not be able to stop this third base from coming down. The Mutalist number is too low. He's just going to be building Lurkers back at home to try and survive, I guess. Because he really does not have much here. And he's only taken a center right base, which has multiple entrances. And will be hard to defend. We're also going to have some Irradiates here. It's not like he beat the Mutalist by going a bunch of Valkyries and knocking them out of the sky. No, he just took a fight with a whole bunch of Marines and wiped out the Muta. And that means we're going to have lots of vessels out here very early with good Irradiates, not having to throw them down on any Mutas. He's able to get the primo Irradiates here that he's looking for, hitting some of those Lurkers. They are very expensive. Each Lurker costs a lot of cash. 125 gas, and what is it? 125 minerals as well. Just doing the math off the top of my head. I believe it's also 3 supply. So trading energy for a Lurker is amazing. Trading energy for any unit is pretty darn good, but trading it for a Lurker is very, very good. And now Calm completely on the back foot here. Oh, he lost the science vessel, I think. One science vessel did just get picked off. A good move there by Calm. But he needs to repeat that multiple times if he wants to bring himself back in this game. He needs to catch a bunch of science vessels here. Otherwise, he is just going to find himself in a worse and worse position as more and more Irradiates come down. He is going to get one, maybe. There we go. He does get one. But taps out. GG. His position was too rough here. Hoping to get like two more science vessels from that last dive, but wasn't able to get it, I guess. He doesn't have many Lurkers here. He's got a little stack of Lurkers, I guess. It is kind of an early tap out, but I guess Calm just getting a little bit annoyed. And being behind in a ladder game is never fun. He decides to tap out and give SSAK the game. Well deserved for that fight and the decision making out of SSAK to hold back and wait for that large army to come in and try to wipe out his Medic Marine and just crush that. Very well done by him as we jump into our next game. Bit of an early tap out there in that last one, but now we're going to have SSAK versus Action spawned here in the bottom right on Retro. We'll see if SSAK continues with this very engineering-based play. That plus one timing with multiple racks, like 4 racks timings, seems to have done him pretty well in that last game, but some of the better players like Queen We're able to pick that apart, and that's where I would place Action. He is at that S tier level of a competition. Someone we always expect to see in the ASL, who's put out some banging games recently in even the wild card qualifier match. If you haven't seen that yet, definitely go and check that out. It was pretty darn fun. I think there's a Tastosis cast of that now on their channel. Definitely enjoyed that. Now we've got the spawning pool down here. After the 12 hatch, when are we going to get this gas here? This is interesting. We're at... Okay, this is a pretty normal build here, but the gas is very late. Here comes the drone to scout. I like it. Actually, I'm going to check the middle of the map immediately. He does not want to get 8 racks here from the middle. No gas. It's going to be a 3-hatch build, I think, guys. 3-hatch build is incoming. Drone heading out to the front, or where is he going to place this hatch? Looks like up here on the high ground. So where is he going with this? What is happening right now? Where is this drone going? I'm going to place the 3rd hatch over here? Oh, he's going to get blocked. Oh, no. All right, gas goes down. What is this drone doing? Where are we going right now? We've had some weird games out of Action recently on KCM. And this is starting to look like a weird one as well, guys. Gotta be honest with you. This is not making a whole lot of sense to me. He's gonna go ahead and take this 3rd base now, but... I mean, we've had 400 minerals for a while. Not what you expect out of a player the caliber of Action, but... He does seem to be a bit off his game recently, honestly. Yeah, in this month, in January, things have been going a little bit funny for Action. I believe this was played on January 30th. Let me just confirm. Yeah, January 30th of 2024. And I think the recent KCM was on the 30th possibly as well. I'm not sure about that. Don't quote me on that. It was a very, very short time ago, though. Maybe like 4 days ago, I guess. But regardless, we've got some Marines moving out, and this seems to be right in Sock's MO. The 4 Marine move out is something that he appears to want to do just about every single game. And he sees that there are 4 Lings out here, so he will not try to challenge that. Had there only been 2 Lings, I mean, maybe he could have come in and done some damage, but... Action kind of producing like the bare minimum number of Lings, which is 4. Not getting overly greedy here. And with the 6th set of Lings, or the 3rd set of Lings, which is bringing that total to 6. Oh, a Hydralis Den on the way. We're going to have a Lurker play here from Action. Now, this is not what I expected. This is very off meta. But you do have to throw in builds like this every once in a while if you want the Terran player to respect you properly. If they're allowed to just save scans and they don't bother to scan you and check you, and they don't bother to like properly scout, then they can get away with more. You know, they can build the scanners later. They can be greedier. But this is going to be difficult to hold. If we do get lurkers over here, there's the first scan. See what he sees. Sees an evolution chamber at the front and a second sunken, and they're both going to be canceled here. He does not see a second gas, which is very suspicious. Why is there no second gas here? We're at 5 minutes 30. How have you not built a second gas? Well, it's because we're linging you all the way across the map. A lot of Lings coming in here right now. He's looking for that Marine Medic Ball, but it's over here at the natural being reinforced. And now he's going to see it. Going to back away here. Does want to catch this. Will he catch it before it gets up this ramp? That would be optimal, but it looks like it will make its way up the ramp, which is a bit frustrating for Action. Second sunken coming down. He's going to cancel one of them. Building some hydras now. Is this a mistake? Sunken here. That's a lot of lings. He's going to go for the bus now. Right as he hits the bus, the lings have to come in at the same time. Here we go. Lings hitting from behind. But pulling back out of range of the sunken colony. Only lost one or two marines. And does get out of range there. Lurkers being morphed. These marines could head over to this base, but Lurker on that ramp as well. Actions thought of every contingency at this point. Evolution chamber on the way. We do not have the hive yet. But as the lurkers drop, Action going to be feeling much more safe. Safe enough to drop the hive. And what do we have here? Tanks on the way. Two more barracks going to come down. And we're going for a very... What would you call it? A fantasy-esque play? Are we gonna... I guess we're not gonna have anything aside from vessels here. So this is a pretty normal response, I guess. This is not like the fantasy build here. We're gonna have the science facility thrown down in a moment. This is gonna really want to get those science facilities, right? Okay. Oh, great. Great, great volley there. Targeting on the Marines coming up the ramp is the right thing to do. But he loses both of his lurkers, which is unfortunate. He could dive on these Marines, actually. Ah, oh, he's not going to go for it. Those Marines were ripe for the picking. After taking some damage from the lurkers and kind of being cut down, there wasn't that many in this group. But he decides to keep the Lings alive for now, just backing away. Two lurkers in this stack here. Gonna be pulled forward. Along with lurkers from these other locations. He's building a creep colony out in the front. He saw the tank with his lings. Realizing that this is gonna be a game of buying time now. Oh no, this didn't build. Come on, we gotta get that defiler mound down. Defiler mound on the way here, and... you know, the amount of time that he needs to buy just increased by quite a lot because that defiler mound did not start on time. We're going to have to buy a little bit extra minutes on the clock here in order to keep ourselves alive long enough for that defiler to come out. Lurker not in position here. Marines are breaking through. Oh my god, he's just going to go for it. This man just does not care. Killing off those sunken colonies at the front. He cuts through that very, very quickly. But a lurker counterattack coming down here. We'll have to go picture in picture with this. I'm going to be paying attention here to the Marines and tank attack. While the picture in picture is happening, he is going to be breaking through here. Oh, the drop into the main is brutal. Oh, man. So that's why he didn't go for that early science vessel. He delayed the science facility by quite a lot. And he was able to get a really nice drop going. Going for the dropship first. It used to almost never be a thing, but it's become more popular recently. We're almost at Defiler with that Consume. Consume is just about to finish. He's being hit. At the hatchery, he lost so many drones. He's down to just 19 workers, 18 now. Oh, I guess back up to 19. One just popped out. Lurker just barely burrows in time with 6 HP left. It finishes off that very, very last Marine, and the lurkers will push forward. He saves himself in this game, but man, oh man, is Action hurting right now. I'm gonna run forward. Pushes the tanks back. He's actually going to be able to come around with this. Darkswarm? Darkswarm? No Darkswarm. Oh, no, that's not good. Okay, no Darkswarm there, but the Lings will come around. And the... oh, God. Marines are going to run right by this. Oh, no. This is really bad. He actually needs another Darkswarm here, but he doesn't have the energy for it. Could target down this one Defiler. He will get the Defiler running by here. Looks like the Lurkers and Lings will be able to clear this up, but so much pressure has come from these attacks so far. At only 18 drones, what can Action hope to do against this? Oh, he's gonna get big hits from these first few lurkers here. Absolutely massive connections with those spines. Dealing so much damage. He's slowly pulling these back. And a Dark Swarm will eventually come. There's the Dark Swarm. Gonna consume a drone here. He's using everything in his arsenal to try and make this push happen. He's pulling the drones back now, actually. He did consume one of those there in a moment of panic. He really needs to make this push happen right here, right now. Here comes the Dark Swarm pushing forward once again. One more Dark Swarm does go down. Another burrow here. He will kill one tank. Tank goes down. The lurker number has been reduced severely. Only a few lurkers remain. And we've got these two science vessels, which are in range of a irradiate here. Throwing the irradiate down on that lurker. Gonna run forward just a little bit further. One more Dark Swarm here in the natural, but two Firebats pop out. They do get picked off, but he is there in the natural. The Defiler is dead as well. Can he target down a bunch of SCVs here? Looks like he's gonna try for it, getting as many as he can. Not enough though, and I think that SSAK has just about done it. We're at 9 kills, 3 kills, and 13 kills apiece for these lurkers. But we've got nothing back at home at all here to follow this up. He's going to run one more time for this main base. He doesn't target the Defiler, unfortunately. The Defiler stays alive here for another few moments, but Firebats are going to hit the field and wipe out these two lurkers, it looks like. One lurker does survive with just 16 HP and 16 kills. But won't last much longer. And there it is. The Defiler goes down. GG is called. SSAK takes another victory here. What a beautiful game out of this, man. The push into the natural, absolutely relentless. The dropship first, such a gamble, but it paid off huge here in this game, knowing that, you know what, your Spire was super, super late. You skipped over Spire in the early game. So coming in with that big tank attack, at the same time hitting the main base with the drop, absolutely eviscerated this Zerg player. And that's a reason, a big reason why we don't see just straight up lurker play at the highest level, is that these Terran players are so good at abusing it. They are so good at picking you apart with just pure lurker defense. And the crispness of the tank pushes are so good, man. This Siege Tank, absolute hero here on the high ground with 11 kills. Just raining down hell on all the incoming forces from the Zerg player. Really, really well done here by SSAK. And yeah, that is why we do not see many players go for this play, what we saw Action do. But you do need to mix it in every now and then to throw your opponent off, to make sure that they are always forced to scout you. They don't know exactly what build you're doing. But another very quick but awesome game here as we jump into our next one. Mr. JAEDONG, gonna be our final Zerg player of the night. He's over here at the top right. Did I accidentally slow this down? I think I did. Is that right? I think I accidentally hit that button one too many times to slow down the game speed. There we go. Fastest game speed here has been achieved. We're going to be getting into this one. We are on La Campanella with SSAK in cross map. This is a very interesting map here, and we've seen Zerg players toy with a lot of different ideas regarding that back natural. The third base there. I actually like this base a lot better as a third base, or potentially a third base at another main. I think those are really reasonable options. The eggs at the natural make it really easy to spread a lurker here. And, you know, the opening's really not that big. I know it's not a high ground, so it's not as desirable for a third base, but I really feel like taking the third at that kind of islandy base is really playing into the Terran's hands if they're going to go for a tank push. If they go for a tank push, I feel like it's very, very difficult to keep that extra base alive. It's so close to the Terran to push right to here. No, from there natural to here is just really not that far at all. And as soon as they get there, they can deny that gas, and it becomes really tough for the Zerg. You have to have that third gas online. Otherwise, you're just not going to be able to compete with the Terran players. So I want to see what JAEDONG has in his mind here, how he decides to take this map on as he scouts here with that first drone. Again, another player sending out this early drone. I like to see it. Not as early as some players want to do, but does get that information, sees that it's not an 8-rax. He sees that there's nothing in the middle of the map being built. You see that he did a cross-map scout with this drone. It serves two purposes. You're going to scout the bottom left, and you're going to see if there's anything building in the middle of the map that might ruin your day. And on this map, it is especially important to make sure that there's no 8-rex coming, because right here, you can put a SCV there, and you put a Marine there, and then you mine this mineral with the SCV. You can hop the Marine over, and that is a super annoying play that a lot of Terran players are utilizing that can just absolutely ruin your day. So JAEDONG cutting off that possibility with the early drone scout. He sees that that's not happening. He's going to pop out a few lings here just to make sure that he's safe for now. We'll be going ahead and I think grabbing a 2.5 hatch, but I'm not sure. I didn't see the timing of the gas this game. It's certainly not as weird as... It's nothing like what we saw out of action though last game. That was a really weird build, what we saw action do there. Looks like he's going to hop the SCV over the back. That's a bit interesting. You know, I'm wondering now, what if you did that and built a factory back here and just started making a Vulture? Would that be a good move, or would that be completely terrible? Looks like he's just going to hop a Ling over and stop anything from being built back here, anything from happening back here in general. I think that was a good plan. I guess that's why you wouldn't want to hop an SCV over there and go for a factory. That makes sense. You can just hop one Ling over and kill that. Did not think of that. You can also do that if the Marine hops over. You can try to hop Lings over. You put the Lings right there, and then you try to mine with a drone and hop the Lings over. It can work, but if the Marine targets down the drone will die very fast. You only get one shot at it. If you mess it up the first time, you are kind of screwed. You have to bring another drone, and things start to get really painful. So glad that we see JAEDONG able to prevent that from happening. Still moving around here with the SCV, and now that the SCV is dead, the Ling is trapped, but it won't be trapped for long. Only 32 minerals left in that patch. Spire here about to finish, and it is indeed that 2.5 hatch here from JAEDONG. So on this map, it is important to note you have to have the creep colony ready. That's why we see the creep colony already done here for JAEDONG, because the push distance is quite short. If the Terran player moves out at you with a 2-rax timing push, you have to have that creep ready so you can immediately morph it into a sunken colony. If you try to bring the drone from the mineral line and build a sunken when the Marines are moving across the map, you are already dead. So that's unfortunate for the Zergs on this map. You just have to do that, but glad to see JAEDONG preempting that, making sure that he has that ready. And now the mutas are here, so he doesn't really need a sunken colony anymore. Just unfortunate that he did have to build that. No two ways about it. But he's going to put down a couple more, and I guess he's going to get pretty aggressive here with his first few muta. Continuously producing... Oh, he's actually making a lot of drones here. I thought he was going to keep producing muta and just have triple sunken so that, you know, maybe there would be a counterattack and he could just dive in and kill all the turrets and try to, you know, take over the main or something. But he's actually built three of these creep colonies. He's ready for the attack across the map. I would be very shocked if he tries to take trades right here. I think he needs to go... Like, if you're going to build this many sunkens, go in and try to kill SCVs. With this many sunkens, you can't counterattack, so... Like, just going in and kill the turrets is probably the best maneuver. Coming in, killing some SCVs, but not killing any turrets here. And it looks like he will just kind of fly out, though there are quite a few turrets back that are dealing quite a lot of damage, and he loses a good number of mutas right now. Building sunkens. We'll be trying to get this third gas, and guys, again, this is going to be rough, but... I feel like build a factor or build an add-on here. Are we going to build tank? No tank? Why not, man? Okay, maybe you will now. Drop it right here and start building tanks because this base is so vulnerable. And he's got a bunch of sunkens here. He's going into hive. There's no way he's going to be able to come out here and stop you from stopping him. Mining at the third base, and we don't even have the gas taken yet. This is a little bit interesting. Focusing more on the minerals right now, although his gas should be the prime resource. There we go. He is gonna go ahead and grab that gas geyser next. We have lurker upgrade almost done. He should put a sunken colony here, because if you don't have a sunken colony here, he can just put marines there and kill this. He doesn't even need the tank, which is highly problematic. We're gonna get some science vessels out pretty soon, but he's gonna try and break this natural. Wait a second. That is quite a lot of marines, but with four sunkens, I guess he's not gonna be able to make it happen. The eight mutas here dealing a lot of damage, really microing that well. Did JAEDONG and two dropship again, skipping over vessel here. No vessel, straight into double drop. Kind of a crazy play by SSAK, but it does seem to be in his wheelhouse. It does seem to be part of his MO of what he wants to do in these games. He's adding on more barracks, and the first two drops are about to pop. Does he have the ability to sneak in on JAEDONG? You know, JAEDONG has a pretty good spread of overlords, but it's not perfect. Can he actually see these drops? No, he cannot. They are going to fly out just outside of his vision. Flying northward here. Where is he going to drop? We've got two lurkers here underneath an overlord at the third. A sunken colony as well. Really nice defense here from JAEDONG, but this is not the main target of SSAK. SSAK is going for his main, I think. I'm gonna load up on marines here and go directly into the main. Here's the scan he is going for right now. Looks like he will lose his command center. That has to be canceled. But the drop is gonna do very well here. Well, lurkers are present. He does need to back away. Stim and back up. Okay, he's going to target down one lurker, but does eat a big load of spines there. Oh, the lurkers are getting caught on top of each other. That's not good. He does save one of the dropships as well. He saves both of them, actually. I thought for sure he was going to end up losing that one, but... managing to save it for now. Hydro's Den is going to go down. Queen's Nest is under threat as well. A new base going to get thrown down here. More drops gonna come in. Oh, he only loaded up one of these dropships. That's all he had outside of the main. Nice dark swarm here with the mutas and the lurkers. Should be able to clear everything out, and he will. Ling's doing a great job here. JAEDONG hanging on. But he did lose the important Hydralisk Den. The Queen's Nest, not really so important. Doesn't really matter. At this point in the game, we already have the hive, so... who really cares? I'm gonna try to come up here and maybe shoot this extractor. He didn't make the sunken, unfortunately, so he may end up losing this. We got four marines hitting that, and it will end up going down. So he loses that third gas. And although JAEDONG has held on pretty well so far... oh, he gunned out his own! Oops! A click on the dropship. He kills his own drop by accident. That is rough. Not what you want to have happen here, but Sock playing a little bit too quick, and he is going to lose this. Oh, is it going to finish? Oh, it finished. Are you kidding me? That's hilarious. Well, it was probably going to finish anyway once he brought some Marines down to clear this out. It's just funny that he managed to actually finish that with the SCV gliding. Pure luck there for Sock, able to get that done, but we finally got this third gas back online. What can JAEDONG do with it, though? He's got adrenal glands on the way. He's going to have plus two coming up pretty soon. Let's take a look at the upgrades here. Plus one is done. Plus two is just about finished. We are even on those upgrades, though, right now. He's going to try and dive in. Can he actually get the kill here in the natural one? Science vessel does go down. We'll be driven back now. Just two lurkers here. One of them will die. Thought we did have a defiler, but I guess that got taken out. Defiler did go down. Try to threaten over here at the third base once again, putting on that pressure. Couple of irradiates going down, one on this lurker, one on some scourge, preventing that from connecting with the vessels is very nice. But what is he gonna do with this now? I heard a big, what was that? Okay, we'll change the colors now. We can see yellow versus green, and we can see that red. What's it called now? We can see the plague here. Hydra's moving out. He's going for Hydralis Defiler to follow this up. That is kind of the way you have to play when you're doing this three-base style. Once he pushes out to here, he can get rid of this and start to take that fourth gas. And it is very important that he gets the fourth gas online here quite quickly. We are already at 14 minutes and third base is already ready for Sock. Sock has that third base down and the fourth base is landing. Here comes the Defiler. With a Dark Swarm, he should be able to hold on. He's looking for the Plague though. Not going to be able to find it here. Mutas will be driven back. More Lurkers being morphed. More Hydras popping out. We have that double macro hatch in the main. More damage being done here. But those Mutas are going to end up getting picked off. Mutas over here at the top center. Along with some Scourge. Great force for picking off dropships or vessels. Little drop over here. In the center right, going to pick off that dropship. Does get that. Hydra's here, going to be available to defend against this drop and should be able to clear this up without too much issue. Little force over here on the left-hand side. Looking to potentially get into this position where the gas can be denied by the Zerg now. We do not have a Defiler in this area here, so this fight is still quite tough. Great single spines line there, actually dealing a lot of damage to some of these Marines. These Lurkers, however, will pop out and die immediately. That was not a good trade for JAEDONG, who's losing a lot more than he's gaining here. Taking a lot of damage from these Irradiates as well as he tries to quickly get his fourth gas online so he can continue to produce these gas-heavy units. Whereas Sock, with now four bases and four gases, no less, is going to start filling the map with a whole bunch of tanks. A great plague there, getting some of these siege tanks down, bringing them into that red HP so that they can be picked off quite a bit easier. He managed to get three tanks there, which is a really good trade for JAEDONG. The problem with this map, if we zoom out, oh, we got a couple of vessels there. Very nice. The problem with this map is if you spread out and put tanks all along here, you can just kind of trap the Zerg player in. and prevent them from taking bases up in the top left or down in the bottom right. He's going to get one more vessel. It did manage to get one last irradiate off, though. And we've got Tank getting healed up here, getting repaired. Another Defiler going to try to come out here. Does he get another good plague off? Would love to see that. There's a good plague there. Dark Swarm as well. He will run forward here, try to pick off the Siege Tank. It looks like he can get that. Getting the Siege Tank here is big. But eventually, this Lurker will go down. Or this Hydra will go down, excuse me. The base in the top left was actually canceled, I think. And another base going to try to come down over here. Would really love to get another base online, but can't seem to do so just yet. Another Dark Swarm comes down. Gonna go after these tanks, and every time he reduces this tank count, big victory for JAEDONG. He's gonna kill another three tanks here and slow down that eventual progression towards, you know, mass tank holding the entire middle of the map, and that is a great thing. The longer that he can hold that off, the longer that he can stop that from occurring, the better chance he is gonna have in this game of overwhelming SSAK here, getting those really good plagues down, you know, getting huge value. You can't really get those great plagues when there's tanks everywhere targeting down your defilers as they try to move forward. Right now, things are very open on the map. We can see defilers, you know, move around the side like this. You can see a defiler come in from an awkward angle and get a big plague on a big group like this. You can see some of those things still happen for now, but if we end up seeing, you know, tanks completely congesting the middle of the map and making it impossible for army to move freely through and around these this Terran force, then things will get very, very annoying and frustrating for JAEDONG to deal with. There's two dropships flying into the main. Meanwhile, an engagement down here in the bottom right is going to be capturing JAEDONG's attention. He does manage to throw down a great plague there and an awesome Dark Swarm, which will give him a great trade. But meanwhile, a lot of damage going down here in the main. Hydras are going to be brought forward to deal with that. They do have plus two armor, but they don't have any attack upgrades. And there's 3-3 on these Marines. So they are trading remarkably well right now against the Hydras, which are just bashing away at them. And honestly, not doing much damage. He's got a target with them. Target down one Marine at a time. And he might be able to kill one. Oh my god, they just live forever. Finally out of energy on these medics. But that thing was just living for an inordinate amount of time. Now running forward here, there are quite a few tanks to contend with. Great plague. Darkstorm will come down as well. And gonna force this back once again, but the damage in the main cannot be undone here. Trying to go after some of these vessels, trying to get a few pickoffs on them. Might have gotten one or two. Does lose those Hydras though. And another base coming down here. A sneaky base from SSAK. Gonna go ahead and grab 6 o'clock, which really can't be scouted here by JAEDONG unless he's got some mutas or something. I don't think he's gonna get dropped this game. It's like these are both rallied onto the Nidus, so he can pop them through into the front of the natural here. Send them to this army. A lot of Hydras here. I don't see any Lurkers with this. He's going to be relying completely on these Defiler spells to take this fight. There's the Dark Swarm. Another good plague here, but the Marine spread is actually pretty darn good. Now, with the Marine spread and no Lurkers to pair with this, Marines are going to be able to drive this back. They could still take this fight with these damaged Marines. Mutas flying around the top side of the map. Fourth gas is online here. But a bunch of good Irradiates are going to come down over here. That is so much value. And I don't think these are going to be punished. Yeah, we're going to lose a Defiler here as well. And that Defiler did consume a few things as well. Very annoying stuff here for JAEDONG, for a Zerg player. He's going to try and push forward once again, but the tank number is becoming a little bit unwieldy. Two more vessels do go down. Some good pickoffs there. But we really do have to pay attention to this tank count. Look at that. How many tanks do we have now? I think we've got a full group of 12 out here in the middle of the map. And the bigger that army gets, the scarier things are going to be for JAEDONG here. Slowly moving the tanks forward, picking up more and more of the map. 180 supply. Very scary stuff. And we don't have much over here on the right hand side. It's really a testament to the play of JAEDONG that he's been able to hang on for this long against SSAK, who's had kind of a better position for a long time since that initial drop, really. But with just very crisp Defiler play, great plagues throughout, he's been able to whittle down this tank count. I don't think he's going to be able to continue to do that, though. You can just see how quickly the Hydras do now die. Even under Dark Swarm against the tanks, they're not going to be able to live for long. They're not like Lurkers, which can hide underground and take zero damage from the tank fire. Once they are under Dark Swarm, underground, under Dark Swarm, the Hydras are still going to take that damage. We're going to make one more Lurker here, but we do not have a Nidus. And this should be the killing blow. The Marines and Medics, Fire Bats are running in here. These few last Hydras are going to try to make some headway here, but the tanks cut them down and GG is called. SSAK punches through. And JAEDONG goes down in this second to last game. Guys, we've got one more game here between JAEDONG and SSAK, so stick around. It's coming right up. Well, after watching this series, guys, I think you can understand why we've been keeping a close eye on SSAK and why I'm doing this series here, checking him out before we get into ASL. He is a beast. An absolute beast. And what have we learned today? Well, we've learned that SSAK really likes to go for early upgrade. He loves to go bio play with that early plus one, that quick eBay into about 3 to 5 barracks and kind of overwhelm you with the Marine Medic, but also get into a very quick couple of dropships. Rather than going directly into Science Vessel, he seems to like going dropship first, which does tend to get shut down by early Mutalist play, but it's so unexpected in this day and age that it seems like it gets some pretty good damage. And this is actually an 8 racks coming out of him this game. So he dropped the quick racks here. He's got the supply depot done as well. He may be putting a second supply depot right there. There it is. He can lift this off and float it back to make a full in wall, but he's full wall in. But he is going to do some shenanigans here in the early game. He's going to try and get a bunker down here in just a moment. And we do not have a drone out right now for JAEDONG, which is a problem. You can see here, the moment that the bunker starts, he's going to pull the drones, but before the drones can reach here, the bunker is almost done. And there's the Marine as well. So now he's actually got to fight the Marine. And the bunker is so close to finishing, he's going to lose one drone immediately. And this is why I'm saying, guys, that a lot of Zerg players pull the early drone. It's so necessary in this day and age. In this current meta. He's going to try and get one more Marine, but he loses another drone. 3 drones have fallen so far. This is a successful 8 racks at this point. We're hiding some drones out on the map because they are very, very low right now. And only producing... Okay, we actually made 6 Lings, but we're... After that, only producing drones here. Recognizing that, yeah, that's going to be enough to push everything back. And we also do need to have some economy behind this because we did lose those 3 drones. We can't just endlessly produce Lings here. He's going to get caught by 4 Marines. Let's see if he produces any more Lings after that. He does. 2 more sets of Lings. So what are we going to do here for JAEDONG? It's not looking to be the greatest, guys. It is not looking like a good situation here at all, but at least he killed the SCV. That's something going for him, right? Because these lings here are not going to get spotted. Maybe there's a chance that he catches all of these Marines right now. If SSAK is getting too feisty with these Marines, if he's out on the map, and we see this number of lings come in, what is this, 9 lings? That could just kill this little Marine force here, and he's got a full wall in. But I mean, he's just parked over here on the right-hand side. If he comes in with this, he could get the kill on all these Marines. He is going to do it. He's going to do it. These lings are going to get these kills. JAEDONG making a great decision here, making these extra lings. I thought this was going to get completely shut down by SSAK after he lost that SCV. I assumed he would be hiding behind his wall, but being too cavalier with the Marines out on the map means he's going to lose a ton of them. And those lings were absolutely worth it. They are going to make a world of difference now in this game. Because they killed those lings, the Mutilus follow-up will be that much stronger, which means we need more turrets out of this Terran player. We need more defenses here. Starting that eBay, I think, just in time. So this is not a quick eBay build after that 8 racks. He needed to get the CC down and get that second racks out here. And so his follow-up is not going to have that plus one ready. You know, once the range is done, that's going to be a much later plus one. So a much less strong Marine Medic timing. And I think JAEDONG can take advantage of this. I think he can get over here with a quick 6 mutas that are going to be popping out. I think the moment this Spire is done, look at the timing on this. He's got 2 larvae here, and there's the third, and there's the Spire. Immediately, 6 mutas should be starting. There it is. Starting up those mutas. Has 4 on the way. I guess he couldn't quite afford all 6. He's going to cancel his Sunken Colony so he can get that 6th one out. He probably will restart that here in a moment. He did drop the 3rd hatchery before building the mutas, so it's a little bit close here. It's a close shave. But he gets 8 mutas in production. He's going to come across with a very powerful attack. And SSAK really having to respect that. Throwing down a lot of turrets here. He just does not have the Marine number that he usually would at this timing. And his main base is looking sparse, my guys. 1 turret? He's got 4 turrets surrounding the natural here. Well, 3 in the natural and 1 here on the high ground. 1 in the main, though. That is a very sparse number of turrets to be defending this main base. Seems like JAEDONG is not going to head into the main, though, unfortunately. And another turret does finish. So that's looking a little bit better defended here. What can JAEDONG get done here? He's going to get one of these turrets picked off and opens up this area for harassment now. But he did take some damage. He doesn't have that many mutas yet, so he's going to wait for another round. Get this hatchery rolling as well. Very important that he get that 3rd gas online. Does lose 1 muta. A little bit unfortunate. Was damaged pretty heavily there a little earlier. Sometimes it can be good to just pull the mutalists out that are damaged. Kind of put them over some impassable terrain like that. And bring them back in once they've healed up a little bit. But that's forgivable. We're trying to get this power spike going. We're trying to get some damage here with these early mutas. Pulling them out of the group never feels good. There's a Marine heading around. It's looking for the expansion, but it will be picked off. And then JAEDONG will be able. My God, it's running so far. Are we actually going to get down here and scout this? That's crazy. Bit of a trade here. Killing off some more of these Marines. Please don't tell me that JAEDONG forgets this Muta down here now. That would be really, truly unfortunate. He needs to get this Mutalist pressure going. He will pull it together. There it is. I'm going to pull out this 1 Muta. Only 9 HP on that. It would be beneficial to get rid of it. Yeah, he is going to pull that out. Very nicely done. Yeah, generally, players seem to pull out their Mutas only when they have like a full group. They're going to start to pull out the ones that are damaged. Going to dive in here now. This is right before Flyer Attacks 1 finishes, so a bit of an unfortunate timing. Plus one is now done for the Terran. So He's gonna have a very strong fighting force here, and the Marines come down taking some good trades, but wow, JAEDONG diving right on top of this, killing off a lot of these Marines. Confidence, absolute confidence is his ability to take this fight right before plus one finishes. That is crazy to me. But he saw the moment, he saw the opportunity, and he seized it. More and more mutas coming. More mutas coming across the map here. He's going to kill off some SCVs. He's going to pick off some Marines here as they come down the ramp to try to assist. The Lings are going to come in now, start to pick off some of these turrets. He's guarding the bottom of the natural here so the Lings can do their job, killing off these SCVs and turrets. Some of them are going to fall to the SCVs that are fighting them, but more Lings are going to come down here. It's just pure mutalisk production right now for JAEDONG. He's gonna pick off one of these supply depots. He can dive on top of these Marines. He's got enough right now, picking off a few Marines. He will come around for the supply depot once again. I feel Valkyrie is on the way. The timer has begun. Two Valkyries, in fact, are gonna pop out here soon, so JAEDONG needs to make this happen. He needs to make it happen now. We're gonna dive in on top of these turrets, start to pick them off. We do not have any Scourge. Okay, we got one pair of Scourges being produced. He's going to fly in here towards the main. He sees these two starports are blinking. He's not sure if this is going to be a Valkyrie play or not, but he's got to have some sort of inkling here. He's going to dive in with both groups of these mutas, killing off more and more SCVs. Now he's completely dominated the natural, but we are going to have those Valkyries popping out. There they are. These deadly, deadly Valkyries. Here we go with the Scourge coming in. He's going to dive on top of all of this, killing off that one Valkyrie. The second Valkyrie did get a couple of hits off, a couple of volleys of their missiles, but this Mutalisk pack is still going strong here. Seven Mutalisks still remain. He can pick off Marines with just one shot. Going to come back in, pick off a few more Marines, and take control of this natural once again. Sock is just about out of this one. He's got one more Valkyrie coming out. Some more Scourge coming up. Can he get the connection on this Valkyrie? This Valkyrie needs to stay alive. Looks like it will just barely stay alive here. And the Mutalisk is still dealing damage over in the natural, picking up more and more SCVs. We are ahead now in the number of drones to that SCV count, although not by much. Just a couple of extra drones here. Very few over there at the bottom left. But it's going to be enough. It's going to be enough to push through here. More Lings coming forward. The Valkyries are out. Going to back off for now. This is a good time to back away here for JAEDONG. Very, very good time. He's going to have Lurkers here popping out shortly. He will be able to start his Carapace. That upgrade will be coming forward now. Valkyrie's moving out. Gonna pick off some of these overlords, which were utilized for that micro. Microing the Mutalisk a little bit earlier. He picks off all the Marines, though, and the Valkyries are gonna start to deal with these overlords. Look at all the overlords that have been sent here by accident, by the rally point, and through microing these mutas. So losing some pretty valuable overlords right now. He does not have that huge economy, just 24 workers, as you can see, two workers down here at the bottom left. He is still getting very aggressive here. He wants to continue to push the issue. Dropship coming out now for Sock. He wants to put some pressure back onto the Zerg because it's just been him on the back foot this entire game thus far. And he has pushed a supply block onto JAEDONG for a moment. But it is a tentative position here. He does need to get some damage going. He put down two bunkers at the natural, making sure that he won't die straight up to these lurkers. And you know what? That is a great move. A fantastic move here from Sock to keep himself alive in this. Oh! Good job keeping the Scourge off of him. Scourge are so dumb, guys. They just do not want to connect. But some good micro there from Sock. We got to give it to him. Lurker here at the front. We will have that hive finishing up soon, but Sock still has a chance in this game. It's been a brutal slog from the very beginning. When he lost those Marines out at the front here, things were not looking good. But he's managed to find his way back into this game ever so slightly. He's going to go for a drop down here in the bottom left. Can he get the big damage that he needs to kind of bring this one back? Oh, some Scourge pop out at the very precise moment when he's about to take this fight. Beautifully done here from JAEDONG. He is going to come down with the Valkyrie and pick off the majority of these Midas, and a follow-up force is going to come down, but that was a great shutdown. Killing that dropship before it could really get all of the Marines out there. And oh my god, a massive attack here into the natural. That's going to be it. GG with the drop being shut down and this lurker counter coming in here to the natural. Also, the block on the ramp, perfectly done. You can't even counter and try to kill this base. SSAK decided to move his army out on the map. You know, he was coming down this way with his Marine Medic Force, so he did not have the forces here at the natural to hang on. Damn, what a final game here. I love it. SSAK gets knocked out. JAEDONG takes that win, but man, SSAK is scary, dude. What have we learned here? I think we've really learned that SSAK is not that good at taking on Mutalisk in the early game. Really strong Mutalisk micro and heavy Mutalisk pressure is difficult for SSAK to handle. We saw it in the Queen game. We saw it in this game as well, that SSAK really does struggle to hold off that kind of aggression. And if you keep the pressure on and block the drops, then I think you can take on SSAK in a ZVT. That does seem to be the lesson we get from this series of games. But guys, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had a good time. I'll see you tomorrow.